Thank you for being here on time. So today we will be discussing the glories of the six Goswamis of Brajamandal, the foremost associates of Lord Nityananda Gauranga Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the Lord, one of the main parts of Lord Gauranga's mission was to send the six Goswamis to Brajmandal and to re-establish the places, the divine places of the pastimes of Sri Sri Radha and Krishna. So the six Goswamis were what Gauranga Mahaprabhu has performed via the medium of the six Goswamis. It is the greatest contribution to this world. So today in their eight verses, which are composed by the great Acharya Srila Srinivas Acharya Thakur, who came around at the end pastimes of the six Goswamis, when Jiva Goswami was the leader of all the Goswamis, all the Vaishnavas, Gaudiya Vaishnavas, at that time Srinivas Acharya appeared in this world and he greatly repented for not having met Rupa and Sanatan Goswamis. So in feeling separation from the six Goswamis, he composed these eight verses, which are super excellent in their Sanskrit language and in their glorification of the greatest devotees in creation, because they are actually manjaris, the assistants of Sri Sri Radha and Krishna, the direct assistants. So they became the direct assistants of Lord Gauranga Mahaprabhu also. So we start from the first verse. I will take the slide to the first verse. Please type in the room if you have any questions, or if you want the mic, let me know. All of you can actually chant after me when I you have the verse right in front of you, and I will say one line. You can also try to repeat after me, because reciting the original Sanskrit vibration of this Shad Goswami Ashtakam is also very, very auspicious for attaining the fulfillment of our desires. Krishnat kirtana gana nartana parau premamritambho nidhi. All of you can sing after me. Krishnat kirtana gana nartana parau premamritambho Tambho Nidhi Dhira Dhira जना प्रियौ प्रियकरौ नीर मात्सरौ पूजितौ धीरा धीर जन प्रियौ प्रियकरौ नीर मात्सरौ पूजितौ श्री चैतन्य कृपा बुभरौ भुवि भुवो भाराव हन्तारकौ श्री चैतन्य कृपा भरौ भुवि भुवो भाराव हन्तारकौ वन्दे रूप सनातनौ रघुयुगौ श्रीजीव गोपालकौ वन्दे रूप सनातनौ रघुयुगौ श्रीजीव गोपालकौ सो आई विल ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वर्स कृष्णोत्कीर्तन गान नर्तन परो परो मीन्स वेरी एक्सपर्ट वेरी डेक्स्टरस इन सिंगिंग इन डूइंग कीर्तन एंड इन डांसिंग while singing the holy names of the Lord, Parau. And why they were expert? Because they were always imbued and overflowing with Prema Amritambho Nidhi, with the ocean of pure love. Prema means pure love and Nidhi means ocean. So they were always oceans of pure love and ecstasy. That is why immediately when they used to sing kirtan or hear kirtan, they used to dance in ecstasy. They dance externally, dance in their heart, and always they would rejoice. Their kirtan was actually the greatest gift to the humanity. Anybody who would hear their kirtan, dhira dhira jana priyau priyakarau, whether one would be sober, dhira or adhira, means a person who is agitated, restless person, any category of persons who would come in contact with the six Goswamis, Priyakarau, they would become endeared to him, that person. That person would feel as if the six Goswamis were his eternal well-wishers. Priyakarau, this is the symptom of a pure devotee. Nirmatsarau, a pure devotee is never envious of any living entity, because nirmatsara, matsara means envy and jealousy. So nirmatsarau pujito, and because they were free from envy, they were worshipable by everyone who met them. They actually, when somebody came in their presence, they were awed in reverence. People Nobody had to tell the people that they were the six Goswamis. They would fall on their feet and grasp their lotus feet and worship them, because they themselves were fully absorbed in the ocean of pure love. Shri Chaitanya Kripa Bharau Bhuvi Bhuo. And because they were always connected with Lord Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they were overwhelmed. They were reservoirs. They were like vehicles of his mercy. Kripa Bharau Bhuvi Bhuo. There is only one thing which is higher than seeing Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and that is to see his pure associates like the Goswamis. To have their darshan, to have their vision is even rarer than seeing the Lord himself. Because his pure associates are continuously engaged in his loving devotional service. So Kripa Bharau means they were full. Bharau means full with the mercy of Lord Gauranga. And Bhuvi Bhuo, and they advented in this world, Bhuvi, with that mercy. And because of that, they actually dissipated the burden, sinful burden of on this earth. Bhumi Devi. When they walked on this earth, the earth felt lighter. Bhumi Devi, she felt lighter. She felt that all the sins with all the other living entities were doing, they were being destroyed. With every step, the six Goswamis they took. Bharavahantarako. They relieved the burden of this earth just by their mere presence. This world. Vande Rupa Sanatano Raghu Yuga Shri Jiva Gopalako. I worship Shri Srimad Srila Rupa Goswami Prabhupada, Srila Sanatan Goswami Prabhupad, Srila Raghunath Bhatta Goswami Prabhupad, Srila Raghunath Das Goswami Prabhupad, Srila Jeeva Goswami Prabhupad, and Srila Gopal Bhatta Goswami Prabhupad. Vande means I offer my obeisance. I worship. So we go to the second verse. Anybody has any questions about the first verse? Their kirtan was better than Mukunda. We cannot compare the pure associates of the Lord, but the six Goswamis are like the commander-in-chief of Lord Gauranga's associates, because they came to broadcast his mercy throughout the world, and they even relished it themselves. They broadcasted the mercy by relishing it themselves. That is why they are known as acharyas. Acharya means one who practices. I already explained that, Mihir, that seeing a pure associate is even rarer than the Lord gives his darshan very easily, but he does not give the darshan of his pure devotees so easily. Especially the six Goswamis, they never came before in 864 crore years. Only they come when the Supreme Lord Krishna only comes himself as Gauranga. Then only they come in this world. Because they are the Manjaris in Goloka. They are assisting Radha and Krishna in their Leela so intimately, even more than Lalita, Vishakha and other Sakhis. So they are most intimate to Lord Krishna and Lord Gauranga. And they come only when there is a direct need for the Lord to assist him in his pastimes, especially relishing Radha Bhav. That is when the Goswamis come. So they are very, very rare. They came in Krishna Leela as Manjaris and they came in Gauranga Leela as Goswamis. They don't come in any other incarnation. We start the second verse. You can sing after me. One line I will sing, and this next, the same line you can sing after me. Nana shastra vicharanai kanipunau sadharma samsthapakau. Nana shastra vicharanai kanipunau sadharma samsthapakau. Lokanam hitakarinau tribhuvane manyau sharanyakarau. Lokanam hitakarinau tribhuvane manyau sharanyakarau. Radha Krishna padaravinda bhajana nandena mattalikau. Radha Krishna padaravinda bhajana nandena mattalikau. Vande rupa sanatanau raguyugau shri jiva gopalakau. Vande rupa sanatanau raguyugau shri jiva gopalakau. Did you all sing after me? Of course, you may be in a position where you may not be able to sing, but at least mentally. Welcome to the live Sangha Matus for the first time. So this is the second verse. Nana shastra vicharanai ganipuno. This is the very beautiful glorification of the six Goswamis. They were like churning the nectar of all the unlimited different Vedic scriptures. And they were very deeply thoughtful about all the scriptures. Nipunam is again very, very expert. All the conclusions of the scriptures would effortlessly arise in their heart because of their pure, unalloyed devotional service. Uh, सद्धर्म संस्थापको। And because of the conclusions of the scriptures, they were always aware of the conclusions of the scriptures. That is why they could establish the real religion in this world, which will benefit all the living entities. Sat dharma samsthapako. Welcome, Angelica. So happy that you are here. So what is the greatness of reading the holy books if we cannot share it with all the living entities, if we cannot give the essence to every soul? So the six Goswamis of Braja, they extracted the essence of unlimited holy Vedic scriptures, and they wrote such sublime literature. Rupu Goswami, Sanatan Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, he wrote Vraj Vilas Tava, Tavavali, Vilap Kusumanjali, and Rupu Goswami wrote Hamsa Duta Uddhava Sandesh Lagu Bhagavatamrita Lalita Madhava Vidagdha Madhava. Sanatan Goswami wrote Brihat Bhagavatamrita Dikdarshini Tika Bhagavatam. And Raghunath Bhatt Goswami, he was so absorbed in reading Bhagavatam that when he was reading Bhagavatam, he was seeing Radha Rani, his Swamini. So he was crying so intensely that his Bhagavatam manuscript also got washed off. So they were so deeply absorbed in reading the scriptures, in thinking about the scriptures, how to apply it to humanity, how to benefit the whole world. Sadharma samsthapako. In the Mahabharata it is said, dharmo hitesham nihitam guhayam. In the Mahabharata it is said that mahajano yena gata sapantha, that the real dharma or real occupational religion is manifested in the heart of the mahajanas or the great associates of the Lord, and they can establish real religion in this world. That's why the Lord sends his great associates from time to time to help all the living entities in Kali Yuga. Welcome Dayal Nitai and Ishan Thakur Das. Thank you so much for being here. We are on the second verse of Shiksha of Shad Goswami Ashtakam. On the second line now, I have already explained the first verse. लोकानां हितकारिणो त्रिभुवने मान्यौ शरण्याकरौ. So one of the most important characteristics of a great self-realized soul is that personality is always endeavoring for the welfare of others. Para dukkha dukhi jivera dukkha jane. When the acharyas attain a very exalted position in bhakti yoga, at that time they realize how much the other fallen conditioned souls are missing the nectar, the bliss, the happiness of spiritual life. So they always endeavor day and night, hita karino. Hita means welfare. Karinau means who are working for the sake of the people. Tribhuvane, not only in this planet, but the six Goswamis, they benefited all the souls in the whole three planetary systems in this universe. मान्यो शरण्या करो. Even the demigods in the higher planetary systems and even the lower planetary systems, Yamaraj, they were very eager to get the dust of the lotus feet of the six Goswamis. They were sending out so much powerful vibrations throughout the universe because they were so intimately connected to the Lord. राधा कृष्ण पदारविंद भजना नंदेन मत्तालिकौ. Every night when Radha and Krishna, they perform the intimate pastimes in the Nikunjas, after the Rasa dance, these Goswamis, these Manjaris are there with Radha and Krishna and they are serving them, the divine couple. So they are so absorbed in service to the divine couple, bhajana, that they are almost on the verge of intoxication. They are not in external consciousness, they are fully absorbed in internal consciousness, in the pastimes of Sri Sri Radha and Krishna. Mattalikau. Mattalikau means intoxicated in spiritual bliss. Bhajana. Bhajana means service, worship. Bhajana ananda means bhajana, bhajananda, bhajana nandena mattalikau. The more we are absorbed in the bliss of devotional service, the more we become untouched by the three modes of material nature. This material environment cannot affect us, even though we are engaged externally or apparently in material activities which look like material activities. But if we are mattaliko, like the six Goswamis, then we are always transcendental. जीवन मुक्तस उच्यते वंदे रूप सनातनो रघुयुगौ. आई ऑफर माई हम्बल ओबेसेंसेस टू श्रील रूप गोस्वामी, टू श्रील सनातन गोस्वामी, श्री रघुनाथ भट्ट गोस्वामी, श्री रघुनाथ दास गोस्वामी, श्रील जीव गोस्वामी एंड श्रील गोपाल भट्ट गोस्वामी. एक्चुअली आई फील सो मच हैप्पीनेस वाइल जस्ट इवन चैंटिंग देयर नेम्स. The names of our acharyas are very, very holy. Just like when you are attacked by a thief, you don't call the police commissioner, but you call the policeman, one who is protecting the streets. Similarly, the example is given by one acharya that when one is in trouble in life or when one is wants to cry to the Lord, one should cry the names of his associates. They are the policeman. They are protecting us because they understand our condition. The Lord is so busily engaged in his pastimes that sometimes he is too busy for us. But his associates, like the six Goswamis, they are working for our welfare. So they are always eager to help us. Any questions? The second verse. We have to move a little fast. We have completed 30 minutes now. We are just done 2 verses. There are totally 8 verses. So please ask your questions or comments. I told that Mihir, he's absorbed in his pastimes continuously. Vishwanath Chakrabarti Thakur describes in Madhurya Kadambini that the Lord is so absorbed in his pastimes that sometimes his cognizance of the whole creation that his feature goes little into the background. He's so absorbed in playing his flute, calling Radharani, and he's so absorbed in dancing in Kirtan as Gauranga. So that is why he sends his pure devotees to help us, who fully dedicate their life to saving all the living entities. Even though the Lord is present as the Paramatma, Paramatma in our heart, the super soul is always conscious about our situation. The original Lord in Goloka, he is more concerned about his pure devotees. Of course, he is concerned about every living being. They are his part and parcels. They are within him. But still, it is different as well as non-different. Achintya Bheda Bheda. He thinks of us as well as he does not think of us. He is engaged in his pastimes. Because all contradictions can exist in God simultaneously. We'll go to the third verse. Please keep on typing your questions. I will take them as you type. Shri Gauranga Gunanuvarnana Vidhau Shraddha Samridhyanvitau. All of you can chant after me. Shri Gauranga Gunanuvarnana Vidhau Shraddha Samridhyanvitau. Papottapa Nikrantanau Tanubhritam Govindaganamritai. Papottapa Nikrantanau Tanubhritam Govindaganamritai. Anandambudivardhanaika Nipunau Kaivalya Nistarakau. Anandambudi Vardhanaika Nipunau Kaivalya Nistarakau. Vande Rupa Sanatanau Raghuyugau. Shri Jiva Gopalakau. Vande Rupa Sanatanau Raghuyugau. Shri Jiva Gopalakau. Shri Gauranga Gunanu Varnana Vidho. The six Goswamis of Vrindavan, they were primarily glorifying the divine qualities of Lord Gauranga Mahaprabhu. And in this way, they were increasing the and nourishing and nurturing the faith in the hearts of all the living entities. Shraddha, Samriddha. Samriddha means to increase, to expand the faith. Shraddha means faith. And how they increase the faith of all the souls? By stressing on the mercy and the glories and the pastimes and the holy names of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. This is what I have been trying to tell the world right from the beginning of my preaching. That if one wants to increase the faith in Krishna Naam, in Krishna Dham, in Krishna Leela, in the characteristics of Lord Krishna, one has to first understand Nityananda and Gaurang. The knowledge of Nityananda and Gauranga's glories, their names, pastimes, abodes, associates, that knowledge increases our faith exponentially. For bhakti to Lord Krishna, Shraddha Samriddhyanvito. And that faith is the root cause of destroying all our sins. Hari Bol. Welcome, Vipul Bhai. Hari Bol. So the next verse is Papottap Nikrantanau Tanubhritam. That when we develop faith in Nityananda and Gauranga, even a little bit of faith, then it destroys all our sins. Nikrantanau. Pauttapa, and all the disturbances in our life, they are also destroyed and removed. Govinda Ganamritai. Tanubhritam. Tanubhritam, we are all Tanubhritam because we are actually covered by our bodies and we are the spirit soul inside our body. We have accepted this covering. There are two coverings, the subtle body and the gross body. The subtle body consists of mind, intelligence and false ego. And the gross body contains air, water, fire, air and ether. So Tanubhritam, we are embodied souls who are trying to attain freedom from this bondage of this material world. So the sequence of liberation is given in these first two lines. In actually these first three lines in this verse. First, we have to understand Nityananda and Gauranga's glories. Then we have, that will nourish our faith, expand our faith. And then the second line, all our sins will be destroyed and we will start singing the glories of Lord Govinda or Lord Krishna. Govinda means his name will start giving happiness to our senses. We will start feeling some bliss while chanting Krishna's names. Gana Amrita. Amrita, the nectar of Krishna's names, can be attained by those whose faith has been strengthened by Nityananda Gauranga Bhajan. Anandam Budhi Vardhanaika Nipunau. And once one gets absorbed in the nectar of Govinda Gana Amrita, then one further understands the position of the six Goswamis and one dives deep in the ocean of nectar in the form of their vani or instructions, their writings, their teachings. Nipuno. And the spiritual happiness is constantly increased by the Goswamis. They constantly increase the happiness of all the living entities to the extent that those who perform bhajan under the shelter of the six Goswamis, for them even going to Brahma Jyoti, liberation or mukti or moksha, kaivalya, it has many words, it becomes distasteful, nistarako. The six Goswamis actually deliver us from this crocodile of liberation. Because if we get liberated and we get merged in the impersonal effulgence, the light between the material and spiritual creations, we will get forever stuck there. We cannot enter into the spiritual planets, which is higher than liberation. It is the dynamic nature of the soul to enter into a spiritual planet, and that is hampered if we attain liberation. कैवल्य निस्तार को. सो द सिक्स गोस्वामीज आर लाइक एक्सपर्ट डॉक्टर्स, दे डिलीवर अस फ्रॉम दिस ऑब्स्टिकल ऑफ इवन लिबरेशन. कैन इमेजिन द डेप्थ ऑफ देयर मर्सी. कैवल्य निस्तार को वंदे रूप सनातनो रघुयुगौ श्री जीव गोपाल. आई ऑफर माय हम्बल ओबेसेंसेस टू रूप गोस्वामी, सनातन गोस्वामी, रघुनाथ भट्ट गोस्वामी, रघुनाथ दास गोस्वामी, चलो जीव गोस्वामी एंड गोपाल भट्ट गोस्वामी. विल मूव टू स्लाइड 4. इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस प्लीज टाइप. All of you are quite silent today, maybe because the topic is advanced. Shall we move to verse 4? If you don't have any questions, we will start verse 4. Are all of you ready to sing after me? Okay, let's sing the verse 4 together. Tyaktva turnam ashesha mandalapati shrenim sada tuchhavat. Tyaktva turnam ashesha mandalapati श्रेणीं सदा तुच्छवत् भूत्वा दीन गणेश कौ करुणया कौपीन कंठाश्रितौ भूत्वा दीन गणेश कौ करुणया कौपीन कंठाश्रितौ गोपी भावर सामृताब्धि लहरी कल्लोल मग्नौ मुहुर गोपी भावर सामृताब्धि लहरी कल्लोल मग्नौ मुहुर वंदे रूप सनातनो रघुयुगौ श्री जीव गोपालकौ. सो इट्स अ वेरी एक्स्टैटिक वर्स. एक्चुअली आई विल ट्राई टू गिव अ समराइज्ड एक्सप्लेनेशन. These verses are so beautiful that they need a very long time to explain them fully, to understand them. Tyaktva turnam. त्यक्त्वा तूर्णम अशेष मंडलपति मीन्स दिस सिक्स गोस्वामीज वर वेरी वेरी रिच, मटीरियली रिच, बिकॉज दे वर द मिनिस्टर्स and they had boatloads of gold coins, and they had so much wealth and so much opulence, material opulence. But when it came to the thought of helping the living entities in this world, of trying to establish Brajamandal and first meeting the Lord and then fulfilling his mission in this world, the six Goswamis, they gave up. Tyaktva turnam ashesha mandalapati. They gave up all the material opulence. In one second, they considered it very insignificant in comparing to the mission of Lord Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Tuchavat. They did not even think twice. It was very highly insignificant to them because they were so deeply in love with the Lord. Bhutva adhina Ganesh kau karunaya. And they themselves assumed a very humble position. Dina, dina, bhutva dina. Dina means great humility. Because if you want to preach in this world the message of the Lord, the holy names of the Lord, you can only become successful if you have humility inside your heart. Without humility, no one can preach. Bhutva dina Ganesh karunaya. And jive daya name ruchi Vaishnava sevan karunaya. And because they were so humble in their heart and constantly associating with the Lord, they felt compassion. Jive daya karunaya. For all the living entities. And kopi na kantha ashrito. And they just wore some loincloth in the quest to relish that happiness of divine love for the Lord and to distribute it to everyone. Gopi bhava rasamrita abdi lahari kallol magnav muhur. Muhur means constantly, every second, and magnav is absorbed. And rasamritab, the lahari, lahari means the wave, waves, unlimited waves were arising in their heart, in their mind, in their soul, in the pastimes of the Lord, and they were so absorbed. Gopi bhava rasamritab, the lahari. I just want to tell you that. Matus, I have made you a presenter, so in case I get disconnected from this room, you can stop the event, then the recording will be saved till that time, otherwise the recording will be lost forever. So I mean, Gopi bhava rasamr, because they, in their spiritual form, inside, in their heart, within, in their siddha deha, they were constantly, they were actually gopis, they were serving Radha and Krishna. So, no, the recording is already on. You don't need to start it, it's already working. And by chance, don't press the stop event button as long as I'm there. In case I not there, then you can stop the event. Yes. Yes. So, constantly, every moment, they were externally living in Vrindavan, in Brajamandal, and internally they were rendering direct service to the Supreme Lordships. In their eternal pastimes. So we go to verse number 5. All of you can sing after me. कूजत कोकिला हंस सारस गणा किरणे मयूरा कुले. प्लीज ऑल ऑफ यू दोज हू कैन सिंग प्लीज डू सिंग दिस वर्स वेरी ब्यूटिफुल. कूजत कोकिला हंस सारस गणा किरणे मयूरा कुले. नानारत्न निबद्ध मूल विटप श्रीयुक्त वृंदावने. नानारत्न निबद्ध मूल विटप श्रीयुक्त वृंदावने. राधा कृष्ण महर्निशं प्रभजतौ जीवार्थ दौयौ मुदा. राधा कृष्ण महर्निशं प्रभजतौ जीवार्थ दौयौ मुदा. वंदे रूप सनातनो रघुयुगौ श्रीजीव गोपालको. वंदे रूप सनातनो रघुयुगौ श्रीजीव गोपालको. So, kujata kokila hamsa saras gana. This is the description of Vrindavan, the Brajamandal, the forests, the 12 forests of Brajamandal, which occupy 186 miles, the most beautiful, perfect abode of the Lord, where cuckoos and swans and various birds like peacocks, they were constantly singing and moving in full consciousness of the Lord's pastimes. Everything is fully conscious in Brajamandal and in Navdeep Mandal and in Puri Mandal. In these three dhams, every soul, in these eternal dhams, I mean, every one is an associate of the Lord, including peacocks and cuckoos and swans. They are fully conscious of the Lord's pastimes and they are crying in happiness. They are singing the Lord's glories. So here Srinivas Acharya Thakur is talking about the internal realizations of the six Goswamis. They were realizing the whole dham in their heart. Nana ratna nibaddha moola vitapa Shri Yukta. Shri means Radharani and whole Vrindavan is always Yukta. Yukta means engaged in the service of Shri Radha Rani. Dana ratna nibaddha, and there are all the trees are desire trees, very extremely beautiful, and different kinds of diamonds and emeralds and rubies and jewels are embedded in the roots of all these trees. They are very luxuriant and very opulent. राधा कृष्ण महर्निशं प्रभजतौ जीवार्थ दौयौ मुदा. सो डे एंड नाइट दी सिक्स गोस्वामीज दे वर प्रभजतौ मीन्स दे वर इंटेंसली वर्शिपिंग राधा एंड कृष्ण. अहर्निशम इज नाइट, अहर मीन्स डे, प्रभजतौ. And because they were in direct contact with Lord Gauranga and Shri Shri Radha Krishna, they knew what is the real welfare of all the living entities, because the Lord is the Supreme Father of everyone. So they knew what to do. It is so sad and it's so unfortunate that after 400 years of their disappearance, 450 years, Now nobody in the world knows about them. Nobody remembers them, even though they have toiled, they have endeavored so hard for delivering all the living entities. They were fully self-liberated, realized what need they had to write so many books. What need they had to reveal all the holy places which Krishna performed. It was a total forest before they went to Vrindavan. There was nothing, it was all jungle. But they revealed these places where Lord Krishna performed his pastime for our benefit. They took the trouble, they went in deep into the jungles. They were animals, ferocious animals. So one day, Rupa Sanatana Ragu Yuga Shri Jeeva Gopal. I worship Srila Rupa Goswami, Srila Sanatana Goswami, Srila Raghunath Bhatta Goswami, Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, Srila Jeeva Goswami, and Gopal Bhatta Goswami. We go to slide number 6. Please let me know if you have any questions, please type. Sankhyapurvaka nama gana natibhi kalavasani kritau. Sankhyapurvaka nama gana natibhi kalavasani kritau. Nidrahara vihara kadi vichitau. Chatyanta dinau chayau. Nidrahara vihara kadi vichitau. Chatyanta dinau chayau. Radha Krishna guna smruter madhurima. Nandena sammohitau. Radha Krishna guna smruter madhurima. Nandena sammohitau. Vande Rupa Sanatano Raghu Yugau. Shri Jeeva Gopalakau. Vande Rupa Sanatano Raghu Yugau. Shri Jeeva Gopalakau. So one of their main essential characteristics of their life, of the six Goswamis, was that even though they were fully perfect and liberated and eternal associates of the Lord, they descended from the spiritual world, they did not take birth because of their karma, like us. They directly descended. Their activities are known as leelas, not karma. Leela is the direct opposite of karma. Karma means we are bound to suffer and enjoy the reactions, whereas leela is we are free to act. So even though they were perfect, liberated, they set a very high example for all of us. Because unless they practice yadyad acharati shrestas tat tat eve tarojana, whatever great personalities practice, the common people, they follow. So they set a very high example. Sankhya Purvaka Nama Gana Natibhi. Their chanting was in a fixed quantity every day. Sankhya means quantity. Nama means the chanting. Gana means singing. And Natibhi, Natibhi means obeisances. Even they used to offer a fixed number of obeisances every day to the deities. In Brajamandal they used to offer, like Raghunath Das Goswami used to offer 100,000 times obeisances every day to the different deities in the temples of Brajamandal. Can imagine that? They used to offer obeisance to even the trees and all the eternal residents of the holy abode of Vrindavan. And everything they used to count. They wanted to show us that we should also count. We should also take a vow of chanting a fixed number of holy names every day. That is like a vow, sankhya. And our offering to the Lord. The Lord does not want numbers, but it is our offering. It's some discipline. We show we are serious if we take a vow to chant a fixed number of names. So the six Goswamis were setting the example. Some of them chanted 200,000 names every day and offered 100,000 obeisances to the Lord. And in that way they conquered Nidra Ahara. Nidra means sleep, Ahara means food, and Vihara means movement, recreation. They all these three things, eating, sleeping and recreation, wandering, they conquered it. They were fully in control. Raghunath Das Goswami, after Rupen Goswami and Sanatan disappeared, Raghunath was eating, he was drinking only one palmful of buttermilk, only once in 3 days. He conquered eating fully. Sanatan Goswami was so oblivious of his material situation, he was so absorbed in the Lord that he was eating dry rotis, and he would offer the Lord that. And Madan Gopal, Madan Mohan, he asked Sanatan for some salt. Sanatan said, "My dear Lord, you find your own salt. I am so absorbed in your bhajan." So they conquered, and the Lord was so happy to eat that offering of Sanatan. Chatyanta dinau chayo, that he left Chobe's house, Chobe Brahman's house, and came to Sanatan. Chatyanta dinau chayo, and because even though they were so exalted, they had conquered eating, sleeping, mating, defending, and they were having performing so intense worship or bhajan, even then they were extremely humble. Chatyanta dinau chayo. The more one advances in spiritual realization, the more one becomes humble. So that is a characteristic of an advanced personality. Radha Krishna Guna Smruter Madhurima. Madhurima means the beauty, the exquisite beauty of the divine qualities of Radha and Krishna. Krishna has 64 qualities and Radha has 25 divine qualities. So by remembering these qualities, and from qualities come the pastimes. So they were so absorbed in remembering those pastimes that they became, in that happiness, they became enchanted. Sammohito means enchanted, totally. Vande Rupa Sanatano. And they enchanted anybody who saw them. And now we are glorifying them today, we also feeling enchanted. Sri Jiva Gopal, I offer my humble obeisance to Rupa Goswami, Sanatan Goswami, Raghunath, Bhatta Goswami, Raghunath, Das Goswami, Jiva Goswami, and Gopal Bhatta Goswami. We go to the seventh slide. As the slides advance, even the context, content matter of the slides are becoming more deeper. The each verse, Srila Srinivas Acharya Thakur is going more and more deeper into the describing the characteristics of the six Goswamis. Radha Kunda Tate Kalinda Tanaya Tire Chavamshi Vate. Radha Kunda Tate Kalinda Tanaya Tire Chavamsi Vate. Premonmadavashadashadoshaya Grastau Pramattau Sada. प्रेमोन्माद वशाद शेष दशया ग्रस्तौ प्रमत्तौ सदा गायन्तौ च कदा हरेर्गुणवरं भावाभिभूतौ मुदा गायन्तौ च कदा हरेर्गुणवरं भावाभिभूतौ मुदा वन्दे रूपसनातनौ रघुयुगौ श्रीजीव गोपालकौ वन्दे रूपसनातनौ रघुयुगौ श्रीजीव गोपालकौ। यस दिस विपुल भाई दिस दिस एट वर्सेज आर सुपर एक्सलेंट इन देयर कंपोजिशन एंड इफ वी जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड अ ड्रॉप ऑफ संस्कृत देन वी विल फील वेरी हैप्पी वेरी वेरी हैप्पी इवन वी गेट ड्रॉप ऑफ देयर मर्सी। राधा कुंड तटे कलिंद तनया when they used to feel greatly intoxicated and maddened by the love for Radha and Krishna, the six Goswamis used to roam about, wander on the bank of the Jamuna, Kalinda. Kalinda, Tanaya means the banks, Tanaya means the bank, Tire, Tira means the banks. And Radha Kunda and Vamshi Vata, there is a Vamshi Vata in Vrindavan, there is a Vamshi Vata in Bhandirvan, there are two Vamshi Vatas. In Brajmandal, where Krishna played his flute, even the trees, you can hear vibration in the trees if you put your ear there. So they used to wander about in these places, remembering the pastimes of the Lord. They used to get so absorbed in the trance, and especially Radha Kunda, that is the topmost place, the pastimes of Radha and Krishna every day in the afternoon, 10:30 to 3:30. Radha Krishna performed their pastimes there. So they used to remember those. We have bhajan kutirs of the six Goswamis around Radha Kunda. Even Chaitanya Charitamrit was written on the banks of Radha Shama Kunda by Krishnadas Kaviraj. Premonmad vashada shesh dashaya. And who can describe their condition? Dashaya means they were totally unmad, means over, these words cannot describe their condition. And the ashtasatvika vikar, the uddipan, the alamban, and they were feeling the vyabhichari bhavas, vashad, ashesh, ashesh, unlimited emotions they were feeling, grastav, and they were so absorbed in that. Pramattav, sada. Sada means constantly, you know, they were never in maya, they were never touched by illusion even for a moment. Because they were every single moment they were with Krishna. Gayantau cha kadaharer gunavaram. And then their internal happiness would get reflected in the external way when they used to loudly sing Lord's glories, his qualities. Bhavabi bhutau, becoming so much overwhelmed with happiness. Muda, muda means happy. Bhavabi bhutau means the bhavas, the emotions, the divine sentiments would overwhelm them by when they sing externally. You see, internally when one feels happy, it overflows out externally in the form of Nama Kirtan. Nama Sankirtan is the expression of the inner joy one feels by chanting his holy name. We chant loudly. The Nama, Gayantau, Gayantau means loud chanting. One should never become ashamed of loud chanting. Because that is expression, the beautiful, beautiful expression towards the Lord. Vande Rupa Sanatana Raghu Yugau Shri Jeeva Gopal. I offer my humble obeisances to Rupa Goswami, Sanatan Goswami, Raghunath, Bhatta Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, Jeeva Goswami and Gopala Bhatta Goswami. And we go to the very last verse now. Our time is already more than 1 hour, 1 hour 10 minutes. So this last verse is very ecstatic verse. It teaches us the mood of separation. which the Goswamis used to feel from Radha and Krishna and from Gauranga Mahaprabhu. The mood of separation is the most powerful way to attain the Lord. Unless one feels separation from the Lord will never come to us. So one should cultivate this mood of separation. One should hanker for the Lord's association. One should plead and beg to the Lord, "My dear Lord, I cannot live without you. Please come before me." Hey Radhe Braj Devi ke chalalite, हे नंद सुनो कुतः, हे राधे ब्रज देवी के चललिते, हे नंद सुनो कुतः, श्री गोवर्धन कल्प पाद पतले, कालिंदी वन्ये कुतः, श्री गोवर्धन कल्प पाद पतले, कालिंदी वन्ये कुतः घोषन्ताविति सर्वतो ब्रजपुरे खेदैर्महाविह्वलौ घोषन्ताविति सर्वतो ब्रजपुरे खेदैर्महाविह्वलौ वन्दे रूपसनातनौ रघुयुगौ श्री जीव गोपालकौ वन्दे रूप सनातनौ रघुयुगौ श्री जीव गोपालकौ. They used to chant, "Hey Radha, hey Radhe, hey Vrajadevi ke, oh Vrajadevi, oh Lalita, oh Vishakha, oh Nanda, Suna." Nanda Suno means Krishna, the son of Nanda Maharaj. Where are you? Where are your pastimes going on right now? We want to see them. Please show us your loving face. Please become united with Radha and perform your divine pastimes. Shri Govardhana Kalpa Pada Patale. Are you under the tree? The divine celestial trees in Govardhan. Are you resting under the shade? O divine couple, where are you? Are you on the banks of the Jamuna? And in that way they got Leela Spurti. Wherever they used to go, they used to see those pastimes happening. Even though they were feeling separation from the Lord. Separation comes from a very strong feeling of union. When there is union, then one feels very strong separation. So both are related very intimately. Kalindi vane kuta. Goshantav viti sarvato Brajapure. Goshantav means searching. They were searching everywhere in Brajapura, Brajamandala, Khedair. They could not even bear even one moment of separation. Mahavivvalo. Maha means great and vivvalo means spiritually agitated. It's a divine ecstatic agitation. One feels restlessness without the Lord's association. That is very, actually it is a very happy thing. Just like when the Krishna left the gopis in the middle of the rasa dance, he disappeared. The gopis started searching. Mahavivvalo. The same mood is this the six Goswamis. They became so absorbed in the Lord that they started enacting his pastime. They started seeing him everywhere in the trees, in the river, Jamuna, in wherever they used to see the face of Radha and Krishna. Vande Rupa Sanatano Raghuyugau Sri Jiva Gopalako. My humble obeisances, my prostrated, respectful obeisances to the six Goswamis, Srila Rupa Goswami, Srila Sanatan Goswami, Srila Raghunath, Bhatta Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, Srila Jiva Goswami, and Gopal Bhatta Goswami. Today I have done an humble attempt to glorify their divine pastimes. These eight verses are very dear to me. So is the author of these verses, Srila Srinivas Acharya Thakur. He is also Manjari. So, Gopi in Radha Krishna's pastimes. Only a Manjari can write like this. So, he is also... This humble attempt to glorify the six Goswamis and Tandera Charano Sevi Bhakta Sanevas Janama Janame Hoy Eyabilas. Narottam Das Thakur says that my only desire is to serve the lotus feet of the six Goswamis and reside in the association of their devotees. Jai Pancha Gras Radha Krishna Nitya Leela Karila Prakash He Chai Goshai Jabe Braje Kaila Vas. The six Goswamis, they stayed in Braja and they revealed all the pastimes of Radha and Krishna. Nitya Leela, they revealed the eternal pastimes, the eightfold daily pastimes which are going on. There are eight sections of the day. Each is 3 hours each. So these pastimes which are going on, they revealed it to the world. Yes. So, life after life, I am only seeking the dust of the lotus feet of the six Goswamis. And Ananda Bolo Hari Bhajo Vrindavan, an eternal residence in the Lord's holy abode. Thank you, all of you, for being present today to hear the sublime eight verses. I hope you will read and recite these eight verses sometimes when you feel like. Hari Hari Bol Gaur Premanande. This video of this recording will be available within 15 minutes online. It will be posted on our website, so you can pass it on to your friends, devotees, those who have missed it. To understand the glories of the six Goswamis is very important. Please tell your devotee friends and anybody whom you know to hear this presentation. Thank you. The hearers, the listeners are as glorious as the speaker. So all of you are also very... Thank you. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to the assembled devotees. Glories to the assembled devotees. Nitya. Ananda. Gauranga. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. Bharati Mataji, she is my mother. She is also kindly graced us in this room. And I am so happy in association of all you devotees. Please try to bring. We have a maximum capacity of 25 devotees. I'll be announcing the topic every day on our website, on Twitter, on Facebook. So please try to bring other devotees whom you know personally. Thank you very much. I will end the room now. Gaur Premanande.